Now, here is something that I have not done in a while, a Naruto chapter prediction video. The main thing, for my long-time subscribers know that my main thing I used to predict was who is going to get the Rinnegan and why. And ever since that has been, confirmed that Sasuke is the one with the Rinnegan, there hasn't really been that much in the latest Naruto chapters that I can predict that I haven't already said, or that isn't just straight up just in your face obvious. So I don't want to give you guys a video of saying, okay, I think Naruto and Sasuke are going to defeat Kaguya. I mean, like, in my opinion, the last 15 chapters have not been prediction worthy, in my opinion. I could have made one about how I think that Tenten is going to be the savior of the shinobi world, but that's neither here nor there. Tenten is going to be the next Ten Tails Jinchuriki. And 2 weeks ago, many people have requested me to do a Naruto versus Sasuke prediction, because that's when Naruto versus Sasuke thing arose again. But a lot of people forgotten, I made a video about that like a month ago called Ten Tails Naruto versus Rinnegan Sasuke, who would win? And so that means I did it before it was cool. So I wasn't about to remake a video that I already made like a few weeks ago. I wasn't going to do it. And even this next chapter, Naruto chapter 694, there's still not that much to predict. I mean, I hope Naruto and Sasuke give us this godlike fight. I pray they pull out every single jutsu that they have learned up to this point. I want Sasuke to pull out a black lightning cutting from the sky. That would be awesome. There's really not that much to predict to that either. Now that we know that both of them are going to survive this fight thanks to the spoiler ass movie, I don't understand why they didn't wait to show the sketches to after the final chapter. That would have made more sense, but that just drained the hype from this fight for me. Not saying that I'm not hype at all, because I'm pretty sure it's going to be epic, legendary. I mean, this is the show Naruto Shippuden that we're talking about. It's been going on for years and years, and people have been waiting for this, so I'm hoping that Kishimoto will deliver. But the only thing that I could predict about the fight is what moves they're going to use and who will come out on top, because it's obvious they're not going to die in this fight. Maybe in the movie, but not in the manga. So what I want to talk about today, I want to talk about what's going to happen after the fight. Is Sasuke going to be a good guy? Is he going to get away? Is he going to come to some sort of agreement with Naruto, like not to come close to the village? Is he going to be a rogue ninja? Because based on the sketch, he looks like a traveler. Like, he has the bandana thing going on. He has the V-neck with the chains and whatnot. So he looks like he's traveling around. He doesn't look like he belongs to one specific place, especially since he doesn't have a headband of any kind on. He's obviously not back in Konoha. I'm sure this fight is going to be full of talk no jutsus and flashbacks, but after the fact, I truly believe that Sasuke is still not going to become good, but he's gonna be like, "Oh, you win this round, Naruto, but next time we meet, you won't be so lucky. I'm going to kill you." Some lame, predictable shit like that. Because unless Naruto uses his new Jesus powers and digs up every single dead Uchiha corpse and brings them back to life, I don't see Sasuke going good. I mean, I really don't think he's going to be good in the new movie. He's going to get away somehow. Like, Naruto's going to beat this guy damn near death, and somehow he's going to get away. Maybe thanks to his Rinnegan abilities, maybe he teleports or some shit, I don't know. But I do believe that Sasuke is still not going to be 100% good. I mean, we've had it with Obito, we've had it with Nagato. I do not want Sasuke to be the final villain in the series and then turn good, and then they all live happily ever after. He needs to be the one that sets the bar for the villains in this series. No fairy tale stuff. I don't want the final villain, the very final villain in the entire series. How long has Naruto been running? 10 plus years? He does not need to turn good for the sake of a happy ending in the last few chapters. It cannot happen. But then again, Naruto is all about breaking expectations and saying fuck you to prophecy. So I don't know. Naruto may persuade Sasuke somehow to become a good guy again, but I don't see how that would happen. Maybe he offers Hinata up for so they can run a train on her. I mean, I honestly cannot think of any reason for Sasuke to go back to the village at all, like, besides to the kill everybody. Even if he were to say right now, okay, Naruto, you're right, I'm wrong, I don't want to kill the Kages anymore, I'll release the beast. This guy still has outrageous crimes that he has committed, and he is wanted by just about everyone. I mean, if someone was to kill Sasuke right then and there, no one would care besides, Naruto, some Konoha kids, and, Karin especially. Sakura will go fucking crazy. Kishimoto has set Sasuke's character up to be so despised by the ninja world that he cannot possibly go back to how it was. I mean, he's like Itachi now. He really is. Like, everyone hated him, thought he was a traitor, etc., etc. And no one is going to accept this guy. Now, maybe under the protection of Naruto, but that's still a lame ending. I mean, it would be bullshit if after all of this, Sasuke turned good. So, I'm predicting right now that Sasuke is going to die in the movie. If not in the movie, there's going to be a part three, maybe. Sasuke is going to die sometime in Naruto history. I don't care what anyone says. He has to, man, because there's no place for this guy. He will be like an Orochimaru if he lives. Like, he'll be like an old hermit wandering the lands trying to find out how to fucking take over the world and shit. That's not the kind of Sasuke I want to see. He's actually better off dying. Now, I hate to say that. I love Sasuke. He's actually one of the best rivals in anime history. History, the entire life of anime, period. But, I mean, if he becomes a good guy, people are still going to try to kill him. If he stays a bad guy, everyone and Naruto would try to kill him, so he might as well die. Now, maybe, just maybe, if Sasuke does come to his senses and releases everyone from the Eternal Tsukuyomi, then maybe he can be forgiven for everything that he has done, which I doubt. I don't think laws work like that, even though there are going to be some people in Konoha that are able to forgive him. Maybe. The other villages, I'm not so sure. I mean, especially A, I mean, the Reikage, Sasuke is the reason he doesn't have a fucking arm. Well, he only has one arm now. So cutting off the arm of any Kage has to be, punishable by death, or like 1,000 years in the dungeon or some shit. Now, if Kishimoto can write Sasuke and Naruto's fight to the point where he finds a way to make Sasuke loved by everyone and make it so that he can return to the village safely and it not be a bullshit reason, then I will be happy. I'm all for Team 7 reuniting. I really am. I really am. But I really can't think of anything that Kishimoto can do to make Sasuke loved by everyone and, make it so he can return to the village without it being bullshit. So I'm kind of torn right now. I don't want him to die, but that's the only way that his character can be saved. But all I know is by the end of the movie, Sasuke either better be dead or he better be, a good guy. Because if the manga ends and Sasuke gets away to survive in the movie, and if at the end of the movie he survives to get away for another setup, that would be bullshit. I mean, that's ending the manga just for a movie and then ending the movie just for something else. That would be really fucking greedy of Kishimoto. But in 694, I am looking forward to an awesome fight. I'm pretty sure Kishimoto wouldn't disappoint us. I know he knows how much hype we have in our hearts right now and how long we have been waiting for this. So I don't think he's going to screw this up, honestly. I think this is going to be one of the best fights in anime history. Now, the question is, in 694, will we get nothing but talking again? Because Sasuke says, "Naruto, before we fight, let me tell you a story about how I think a Hokage should be." So 694 may be all dialogue, and we may only get one good chapter or 1.5 chapters of fighting. Although I do want it to last like maybe 2.5, 3 chapters. I don't want it to drag on too long, because we just got out of so many long fights. I mean, the war arc has been going on for years, literally years. In our time, of course, but I mean, I'm tired of shit being dragged out, Naruto. Just give us a good 2 and 3 action-packed, full chapters, and have Naruto standing on top of Sasuke, how Sasuke was standing on top of Naruto at the end of part one, and call it a day. Let Naruto run away, teleport away, fucking swim away, let him pull out a sexy jutsu to distract Naruto, I mean, who knows, but let that happen. I don't want too much talking, and I don't want too much fighting, if that makes any sense. Tell me what you guys think is going to happen with the end of this manga. What's going to happen with the fight and in the movie? Do you think Sasuke is a good guy in the movie? Do you think he's a bad guy? Because he may very well be somehow a good guy, but he's traveling because, of the reasons I said, because everyone is out to get him still. But he looks like he's traveling around because of the bandana and the shirt he has on. He looks like a fucking desert wanderer or something. I don't know. Tell me what you guys thought. This has been JB Dutch. Yeah, like, comment, subscribe, and I'm out.